Today, we're diving into the topic of NDCs, or nationally determined contributions. NDCs reinforce the Paris Agreement's goals to combat climate change. They show us exactly what each country is committing to do to keep 1.5 degrees within reach. Now, NDCs highlight how countries will both reduce national emissions and adapt to climate change. The Paris Agreement requires countries to update their NDCs every 5 years, and the next ones are due very soon in 2025. According to UNEP's 2023 Emissions Gap Report, unless countries deliver more than promised in their existing NDCs, the world is headed for a 2.5 to 2.9 degrees temperature rise above pre-industrial levels. To keep 1.5 degrees alive, the world needs to cut emissions by 42% by 2030. Now, that is a big ask, but it's possible with stronger ambition and action from decision makers and leaders. The next round of NDCs, also known as NDCs 3.0, are therefore going to be critical. NDCs 3.0 need to demonstrate ambitious emissions reductions for 2030 and 2035, covering key sectors of energy, transport, agriculture, land use, industry, and buildings. They need to unlock finance that drives mitigation and adaptation action. They should take steps to increase resilience, plan how to adapt to climate impacts, and ensure that no one is left behind. They must also take the co-benefits of climate action into account, such as healthy nature and green economic growth. NDCs 3.0 need to be fully integrated in countries' national planning and development strategies. They must be accompanied by concrete policy and implementation roadmaps, as well as financing plans. So if done right, these NDCs 3.0 will double as investment plans, spur economic development, and bring us closer to achieving the Sustainable Development Goal. NDC 3.0 are a make or break for 1.5 degrees. It is our last chance to deliver on what humanity wants, a stable climate and healthy nature for the good of everyone, everywhere. Every action counts and every fraction of a degree matters.